Asad Omerjanov, Eternal Dream and Perished Flesh. Eternal Dream and Perished Flesh, Asad Omerjanov.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's my pleasure to welcome you to an open interpretation speech contest. And today, I will not talk about historical events or historical people, at least those who you know. Today, I will talk about a simple man from Wilmington, Illinois, who changed my life dramatically and changed many lives of you, present here today without you even knowing. But today, I would like to resurrect him here in front of you, and I would like to talk as he's standing here. Dear ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to be here. I had only 7 minutes to tell a story which lasted for 100 years. My name is Ralph, just Ralph. You don't know me, and could never imagine that I would see you today. In 1905, I graduated from university. And as any young man, I didn't know completely what to do with my life. Just 6 months after my graduation, Wright brothers invented their first airplane. And I was lost. I didn't have any plan for my life. But you know what? I thought about famous people who I knew. What Jesus did, or Moses did, when they didn't know what to do with their life. They decided to serve and help other people. And that's what I decided to do with my life. In 1905, I became educational director of Young Men's Christian Association in Bloomington, Illinois. My career was rising. I was on top of my game. And that's when the first chapter of my life began. But I wasn't satisfied with my daily job because I saw young men in our organization struggling to convince their messages, struggling to get their passion to other people, to inspire them by spreading the word of the God. And I decided to organize a speaking club, but not a lecture, no. I decided to organize in the basement of our building a speaking club. But how would I attract people? What do every young man like to do? They love to eat. And I had decided to organize dinners. And after dinners, we would give speeches, short speeches, give toasts to each other. And for 5 years, I've been living my dream. I saw so many young people coming there every night and practicing their public speaking skills and getting there in the world and inspiring others. But as any dream, it comes to an end. After every sunset comes sunrise comes sunset. And then the dark night came down to my life. I was promoted. And when I saw my career rising, I saw my dream crumbling down to pieces. I was moved to Rock Island, Illinois, to become General Secretary of Young Men's Christian Association over there. Only after 1 year, I received a letter. My basement club, the dinners and jokes, fell apart. And it shook my heart. But you can be successful, but if you are not living your dream, you are not a happy man. And that's a painful lesson I learned on that day. But I'm not a person who gives in easily. I decided to establish Toastmaster Club in Rock Island. Why not to rock in Rock Island? And for another 7 years, I was living my dream, seeing not only young people, but also women, men, black and white, practicing their public speaking skills. But again, the sunset came to my life. I was promoted again. But I saw my dream falling down one more time. arrived to San Jose, California in 1919. What a beautiful day, but what an awful life here for me. I was not ready to establish another Toastmasters Cup. No, my heart was so broken. I didn't want to break it one more time. I was afraid I could not handle it. But as I say, I am just slightly over average stubborn man. Just slightly above the average. And I decided to try one more time. Because having a dream job, but with your dead dream at the heart, will never make you happy. And I was already 30. I was not a young man. Not anymore. But I still decided to pursue my dream and inspire others. To inspire others. My dream lasted for 5 years. You can guess. I got promoted again. But I was not happy. I packed my clothes, I took my stuff, and I walked to the train station. Because I knew it was coming just 1 year. Failure is awful. But what is even more failure, what is even more awful, is knowing that it will come after you. Knowing that one day it will knock on your door and you will have to open it. And it happened again. In 1924, when I moved to Santa Ana, California, I received a black letter saying that my club was closed down. By that time, I was 40 years old and I dedicated 20 years of my life for the dreams that kept crumbling down after I left behind. I was devastated. For the next 2 years, I didn't want to hear a thing about Toastmasters Club. I didn't want to talk to people. I became a lonely person in my room with a broken heart, but a great career. But on the street I saw a young man, and I looked at his eyes and I realized he was just as stubborn as me. And he started hounding me. You gotta help me to open Toastmasters Club. And I would say, no, never. I will never do it again. But he kept knocking on my door. And one day, he woke something in my heart, which made it beat faster. And I decided to give it the very last shot. 22nd October 1924, when the Toastmasters Club was created officially. In 6 years, in 1930, we became an association with 30 clubs around the country and one club in New Westminster, British Columbia, Canada. In 1932, only after 8 years of my almost devastation and giving up on this dream, we became Toastmasters International. And today, ladies and gentlemen, even so, I died many years ago. And even so, my flesh perished, but my eternal dream still lives on. And you all here, with 340,000 people around the world, in 141 countries, which is almost 75% of all countries in the world, you kept my dream alive. And today, by coming here, you gave me a tribute without even knowing it. And even so, it's time for me to go. I would like you to remember eternal dream and a perished flesh. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.